In this video, I'd like to show how to use the Zeta table to find probabilities. You need a cumulative Zeta table. Let's find out the basic knowledge about the standard normal distribution. It has a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. Please keep in mind that the area under the curve is probability. This Zeta table gives the area or probability to the left of z-scores. The first column shows the first two digits of z-scores, and the top row shows the second decimal place of z-scores. Let's take a look at the first example. First, mark the given z-score -1.83 on the normal distribution. Mark it on the left side of the center, since it is negative value. Once we locate the z-score, then read the direction. We read it as less than -1.83, so we need to find the area to the left of z equal -1.83. Let's look up the z table using -1.83. We need to find the left cumulative area to z equal -1.83. First, locate the first two digits of z-score as -1.8. And then, locate the second decimal place of 3 from the top row. The intersection of those values is the left cumulative area to z equal -1.83, which is 0.0336. The table gives the left cumulative area of 0.0336 to z equal -1.83. And our desired area is the same. So the area to the left of z equal -1.83 is 0.0336. Let's take a look at the next example. First, mark the given z-score 1.16 on the normal distribution. Mark it on the right side of the center, since it is positive value. Once we locate the z-score, then read the direction. We read it as less than 1.16, so we need to find the area to the left of z equal 1.16. Let's look up the Zeta table using 1.16. We need to find the left cumulative area to z equal 1.16. First, locate the first two digits of the z-score as 1.1, and then locate the second decimal place of 6 from the top row. The intersection of those values is the left cumulative area to z equal 1.16, which is 0.8770. The table gives the left cumulative area of 0.8770 to z equal 1.16. And our desired area is the same. So the area to the left of z equal 1.16 is 0.8770. Let's take a look at another example. First, mark the given z score 1.54 on the normal distribution. Mark it on the right side of the center, since it is positive value. Once we locate the z-score, then read the direction. We read it as greater than 1.54, so we need to find the area to the right of z equal 1.54. Let's look up the table using 1.54. We need to find the left cumulative area to z equal 1.54. First, locate the first two digits of z-score as 1.5, and then locate the second decimal place of 4 from the top row. The intersection of those values is the left cumulative area to z equal 1.54, which is 0.9382. The table gives the left commutative area 0.93822, that equals 1.54. However, our desired area is the right of that equals 1.54. Since the whole area under the normal curve is 1, we subtract the left area from 1 to get the right area. So the area to the right of z equals 1.54 is 0.0618. Let's take a look at another example. First, mark the given z score negative 0.84 on the normal distribution. Mark it on the left side of the center since it is negative. Once we locate the z-score, then read the direction. We read it as greater than minus 0.84, so we need to find the area to the right of that equal minus 0.84. Let's look up the table using minus 0.84. We need to find the left cumulative area to that equal minus 0.84. First, locate the first two digits of the z-score as minus 0.8, and then locate the second decimal place of 4 from the top row. The intersection of those values is the left cumulative area to z equals minus 0.84, which is 0.2005. The table gives the left cumulative area of 0.2005 to z equals negative 0.84. However, our desired area is right of z equals negative 0.84. Since the whole area under the normal curve is 1, we subtract the left area from 1 to get the right area. So the area to the right of z equals minus 0.84 is 0.7995. Let's take a look at the next example. First, mark one of that scores minus 1.50 on the normal distribution. Mark it on the left side of the center since it is negative. Then, mark the other z score 1.25 on the right of the center. Once we locate the z scores, then read the direction. We read it as between minus 1.50 and 1.25. So we shade the between area. Let's look up the table using minus 1.50 first. We need to find the left cumulative area to z equal minus 1.50. The intersection of the first two digits, minus 1.5, and the second decimal place of 0 from the top row gives the left cumulative area to z equal minus 1.50, which is 0.0668. The table gives the left cumulative area of 0.06682 that equals minus 1.50. Let's look up the table using 1.25 next. We need to find the left cumulative area to that equals 1.25. The intersection of the first two digits, 1.2, and the second decimal place of 5 from the top row gives the left cumulative area to z equals 1.25, which is 0.8944. The table gives the left cumulative area of 0.8944 to z equals 1.25, which includes the area of 0.0668 corresponding to z equals minus 1.50. To find the between area, we subtract the smaller area corresponding to the smaller z score from the larger area corresponding to the larger z score. So the between area of z equals minus 1.50 and z equals 1.25 is 0.8276. Let's take a look at the last example. First, mark one of the z scores 0.94 on the normal distribution. Mark it on the right side of the center since it is positive. then mark the other Z score 1.97 on the right of 0.94. Once we locate the Z scores, then read the direction. We read it as between 0.94 and 1.97, so we see the between area. Let's look up the table using 0.94 first. We need to find the left commutative area to z equal 0.94. The intersection of the first two digits, 0.9, and the second decimal place of 4 from the top row gives the left commutative area to z equal 0.94, which is 0.8264. The table gives the left commutative area 0.8264 to z equal 0.94. Let's look up the table using 1.97 next. We need to find the left commutative area to z equal 1.97. The intersection of the first two digits, 1.9, and the second decimal place of 7 from the top row gives the left commutative area to z equal 1.97, which is 0.9756. That table gives the left commutative area of 0.9756 to z equal 1.97, which includes the area of 0.8264 corresponding to z equal 0.94. To find the between area, we subtract the smaller area corresponding to the smaller z score from the larger area corresponding to the larger z score. So the between area of z equal 0.94 and z equal 1.97 is 0.1492. We looked at three types of examples: finding the left area, right area, and the between area. In any case, we have to look up the table to find the left commutative area that corresponded to z scores. Please keep in mind that our z table always gives the left commutative area. For finding the left area of the z score, the table area is our desired area. For finding the right area of the z score, our desired area is 1 minus the table area. Lastly, finding the between area of two z scores, larger area with the larger z score minus the smaller area with the smaller z score. Please make sure to subtract areas, not subtracting z scores. Thank you for watching and see you again.